Hello, welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to create stroked interactive text using GIMP. This is sort of like a picture in text effect, except we're gonna have the text be a little bit more interactive with the main objects in the photo. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.22, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. Before I get into that, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of GIMP, Inkscape, and Darktable tutorials on here. You can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member. And I have tons of free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from beginner to pro photo editing on Udemy. And as I mentioned, you can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member, and I'll include a link to this as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. I'll be using this photo for today's tutorial. This is from Pexels. Just click the little drop down. I went with the original size here and click free download. So here is the final composition we'll be creating for today's tutorial. So as you can see, we have some text and the main objects in the photo are interacting with the text, which gives us a lot more depth. So I'll start off by opening up the original photo. So here is the photo I downloaded. I'll click and drag this over to GIMP to this little Wilbur icon and release. And GIMP is asking me if I want to convert this to its native sRGB color profile. I'll hit convert. You can hit keep if you want to keep the original image's color profile. Next, what I'll do is I'll crop this. So I'll come over here and grab my crop tool. So I have allow growing turned off. I've got my fixed aspect ratio option turned on here. So that's just the first option here in the dropdown. And then type 1920:1080. At least that's the aspect ratio I'm using. You guys can use whatever you want. And now I'm gonna click and drag my crop tool across here. And you'll see I have an option for guides. I have my guide set to rule of thirds. And I'm just going to center this up here. I'll hold control and use my mouse wheel to zoom in. So I'm just trying to center up the main objects in the photo. And once I'm ready, I'll just click inside the crop. Next, what I'll do is I'll resize this. So I'll go to Image, Scale Image, and I'll resize this to 1920. Hit the Tab key because we have the little gear icon locked here and we crop this to 1920:1080. This will automatically update to that size. And for interpolation, I have this set to no halo. I have an entire tutorial on how to scale images with minimal quality loss that goes into what interpolation is in a bit more detail. So definitely check that out if you want to learn more about that subject. But now I'll click scale, and that's going to scale my image down. You'll see the new dimensions up top here. So hold control, zoom in. So now we can add our text to this. So I'll come over here and grab the text tool. And over here in the tool options, you'll see my font is set to Poppins Heavy. This is a free font. I have an entire tutorial on how to download and install free fonts for GIMP. But you can always cycle through these fonts here if you want to find a different font. And the size I have set to 650. So now I'll come over here and click on my composition. And with the caps lock key on, I'll type my text. And you'll see that will create a little text layer over here. Next, what I'll do is come over here to my toolbox, and usually the move tool is right here. So click and hold your mouse on that if you have tool groups enabled and choose the alignment tool. And now I'm going to click on the text layer here, and with the alignment tool options set to relative to image, I'm going to center align this both vertically and horizontally. And the last thing I'll do here before we get into erasing some of this text is I'll come over here and I'm just going to duplicate this text, and then I'll just hide the original layer and we'll work on this duplicate. So now we're going to mask out the areas of the text that are intercepted by the main objects in the photo. That's going to make this look interactive. So what I'll do for this is I'll come over to layer, layer to image size. That's going to make this text layer boundary go all the way outside to the boundary of the image. And it's going to discard the text information, which means we can now paint on this and perform any other effects we want to. But next, what I'll do is add a layer mask to this. So I'll come over here and click this little layer mask icon right next to the delete this layer icon. And I'm going to go with white full opacity. Make sure invert mask is unchecked. And I'll click add. Now we have a layer mask on here. If I hit the P key on my keyboard, that will grab my paintbrush tool or you can click and hold on this tool group. And I'm gonna make sure I have a nice circular brush head selected here. Any of these will do. And the hardness, I like setting this to around 90. That way we do have a hard brush, so the edges aren't too soft on the brush head, but they're also not too hard. And we can adjust the size either using the slider or using the left and right bracket keys on the keyboard. Just make sure you're clicked on the actual composition. So left and right brackets will increase or decrease this. And I'm gonna switch my color to black. So anywhere I paint black on a layer mask is going to create transparency, which means it'll hide that area of the text. So I'll hold control and use my mouse wheel to zoom in. And actually, let me come over here and decrease the opacity of this so we can see the objects below. And now what we're gonna do is just paint anywhere where the object and the text intersect. And I can always use the shift key to paint in straight line mode, which I'll do a little bit later on here. But I'm gonna fast forward through this so that you guys don't have to sit here and watch me paint in real time. Just keep in mind, if you hit the X key on your keyboard, you can switch to white. And that way, if you accidentally paint something out, you can paint it back in there. Hit the X key again, switch back to black. So I'll also be doing that as I'm painting here. All right, so I've pretty much finished masking out the various areas of the text here. So now what I'll do is click on this layer again and just turn the opacity up and down and just see if there's anywhere I missed or anywhere we can clean up. So I like to just go back and forth here, and usually you could see little areas pop up that maybe didn't quite get painted out, like right here, for example. There's a little speck. Let's move along here. Right here is another example. All right, so that looks pretty good. As you can see, I only masked out the areas where the main objects, so the rooftop tent and the truck here, were overlapping with the text. So now the main issue here is that the areas of overlap are covering up the text here, so it's really hard to see what exactly this says. So what we're gonna do is add stroke to our text to make the text easier to read. I do have an entire tutorial dedicated to the various ways you can stroke text inside a GIMP. I'm just gonna go with the simplest method for this tutorial. So we did create this duplicate text layer here. I'll click on that and click to show it. And then what I'll do is alt click on here or go to layer, transparency, alpha to selection. That should create a selection around your text. And now we can hide this text layer. And I'll come up top here to the layer with the layer mask, and I'll come over here and click to create a new layer. We're gonna name this stroke, which I've already done since I did this tutorial ahead of time. And I'll fill this with transparency and click OK. So on the stroke layer, we're gonna come over here to the paths tab, and we'll click this icon here to convert the selection to a path. So it says selection a path. So now our selection is a path over here in the paths tab. I'll hit Control Shift A to deselect that, or go to select none. So if I show this path here, you can see now we have the outline of our original text. Next, I'm gonna come over here and just swap my color so that my foreground color is white. That's going to be our outline color here, our stroke color. Then I'll come over here and I'm gonna click this Paint Along the Path option. And so this is gonna be set to stroke line, solid color, anti-aliasing is turned on. That's just gonna make sure any rounded areas are nice and smooth. The line width I'll set to 5 pixels, and the line style I'm going to change to line. And come over here and click stroke. And now we have a nice white stroke going around our text, which makes it nice and easy to read. And let's come over here back to the layers panel. And there's our final composition. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.